What's up, my shopper friends? My name is Remy Kibibo, and today is Q&A Day, which means it's Cyber Thursdays! Actually, it's probably the only Cyber Thursdays actually recorded on a Thursday. So, let's get right into the start of my Q&As, and let's go to the updates. So, I don't have much updates on my hobby-wise, apart from I have a new series that the first episode has been uploaded, so if you want to go check that out, it's in my collection of videos. It's called TNT, which, as I mentioned in the video, is called Tuesday's New Tips. And I will pretty much explain more, in that episode. So, on to just in general, I've been playing a lot of League of Legends with some of my good friends and internet brothers and sisters. And I've been playing League of Legends with people like Darklight Dreamer, Mythos, and Freak from the channel Frost and Fist. I've been playing with Lily Nightfall, and obviously my great, awesomest fiance, Kujahira. It's been a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun here to play with them guys. They are great, good players as well. So that's that. And another thing I wanted to mention is Wolfbrother and Mythos from the channel Frost and Fists. Link is in the description below. Right, we have this thing, me, Kujahira, and Freak. We had this thing going on, and at one point on a private Skype call, Mythos had mentioned about his little pet peeve that if he gets quite there when people pronounce ninja as ninjas and katana as katanas. Now, it was a very big mistake for him mentioning that, bearing in mind of we are a group of friends. We've been teasing him with it. Wolfbrother Mythos has mentioned this in his latest Wolfbrother Wednesday, but pretty much we've been mentioning it in subtle hints. So, Freak did something on the battle rep, Powler, and so it's a lot of fun to us, but he wants probably what Wolfbrother Mythos probably wants to kill us. So not sorry, Mythos. I love you though. So that's pretty much all the hobby updates and the actual updates that I've had going on within the week. I would like to do something like a switcheroo, so I want to give shout outs first before I do my Q&A, because there is a lot of questions. Like, you guys went ham this week. Well, yesterday, but you guys went ham this week. So, I have a lot of questions. This is going to be a long-ass video. Just grab some popcorn, grab a drink, sit back and relax. And there needs to be music playing. Baby, do me a favor, play some music, like, right now. So, my shoutouts for the week are I've been searching, because obviously I do shout out the same people. They are all their channels are always down below if you want to check them out. But there is a few shoutouts that I want to give to my YouTube friends and people that I enjoy watching. The first shadow is Devastated Dolls. Now, this person only has 15 subscribers, but his repaints are amazing. They're very human-like and they're very detailed. I enjoy watching him, and I'm assuming it's a him. If not, just I apologize. But his link will also be hopefully down below. If not, I'll just do a separate comment on my videos or something like that. Or, actually, might do an annotation card, like, maybe there, or maybe there, or maybe, like, here. But, either way, it's gonna be somewhere around the screens at the end of the videos. But Devastated Dolls, give him some love and go subscribe to him. Tell him that Kiwi said hi. My second shout out is not for it is he is a YouTube channel, but he also has a group on Facebook. If you are into wargaming, if you're into wargaming and like seeing people's painted works, go and give Baz's Wargaming Mafia a like, or and there will be a join. If you're interested in seeing their work, I think it's a fabulous page, and they accepted me as a doll repainter as part of the group. So all of you repainters, I encourage you to actually like this page. They are very nice, they are very lovely. So go like that page. Also, what was Baz's YouTube channel? Right. Also, talking about Baz's Wargaming Mafia, Baz actually has a YouTube channel called Underdog Painting. Did I get that right? Right. Underdog Painting. His link will also be down in the description below. Go subscribe to him. He is awesome. I love watching his content. And I think you guys will like him too. So go give him a subscribe and tell him you're like, Kiwi said hi. I'd like to shout out these three people who are Let's Players. I can't remember their subscriber count, but they don't have enough subscribers, so give them some love. Give Mark Mother, Unikai, and Forson subscribes, and tell them that Kiwi sent ya. So those are my shout outs for the week. Go and give them some Donny love and subscribe to their channels. Hopefully I can fit them in the description box below, as well as my good friends Fast and Fist, Eric Bear, 40k, Tattoo for You Richard. Also give Dark Light Dreamer some love as well. So go see those lovely people. They have great content and they deserve more subs than they actually do. So that's my shoutouts and updates for the week. Now it's time for your questions that you have been anticipatingly waiting for me to answer. So I'm going to start off with the questions that Freak, Mythos, and Kuja Hyra asked in their Q&A shows. So I'm going to start off with Freaky Fridays, and Freaky Fridays question is, at one point did you guys reach a level when you are not motivated to paint? I actually had that about a couple days ago. I was having a really bad day. You know, I just didn't want to repaint anything. I didn't want to convert anything. I just couldn't be bothered with it. Again, I was having a bad day. I mean, that was very recent. I think that was about a week ago. Maybe 2 weeks ago. But I just didn't want nothing to do with it. I just didn't want to focus on it. I didn't want to bother to deal with it. I just wanted just a break from everything. So I actually slept all day that day. But about maybe sometime either a week ago or 2 weeks ago, I had that. Hydro Hobby Sunday's question was, what is the best conversion / repaint have you seen and have done in your hobby? So I'm assuming, since I have the man with me, I'm assuming that will be conversions that I have seen from other doll repainters, and also conversions that I have done that I personally like. Yes? Awesome, I got the thumbs up. Right, so we'll first go with the conversion that I have seen that I think is the top best. And if I do this, Now, this up here is a Wendigo made from Skeletor, and this is probably going to be my most favorite conversion. It's from a channel called Delightful. Link in the description below. She does have a great following, but she's awesome and I love her. So give her also a nice little greeting. But Delightful made it. She also has a video making this. So that video will be also linked in the description below. I have a lot of things to put in my description today. So, the best one that I have made is going to be my harpy. Again, let's go this way. It's going to be my harpy. Now, I had spent a lot of time on this particular doll, and I had waited so long for her feathers to come through, and I love her to bits. Now, she is probably one of my most favorite conversions I ever did. So, love the questions. Keep with the content, my lovely bebes. Well, Father Wednesday's question is, what skills do you have outside of your hobby? I have a couple. I draw. I don't draw as much as I would like to, but I do draw, like, when I feel up to drawing. So, like, you know, if I wanted to do a tattoo design, or whether I want to turn you guys into chibis, for example, then that's when I would be, like, kind of dedicated to draw. I love drawing. Drawing's kind of, like, the thing that I do. Just personally, just, you know, casually. I wouldn't say this is a skill, but, I mean, I think of this as a skill, because not many people do have this kind of skill. I'm not saying all of the people, I mean, not everyone, but I have this skill of, I can make people laugh. I have this really great sense of humor. I have a very dark sense of humor, but, I class this as a skill. It's probably like a personality trait, but I class it as a skill. It's very hard to make people laugh when they are down in the dumps a little and they're sad or whatnot, but I love making people laugh, and it's amazing. So that's the two kind of skills I have outside of the hobby. I could play piano at one point, but it's been so long since I actually practiced piano that I don't think my fingers will remember. I mean, I wouldn't say piano, I would say probably keyboard. But piano, keyboard, you know, they have keys and they just sound differently. But I did practice piano at some point. So those are my skills outside of my hobby. I really want to get back into those particular ones. I mean, apart from my sense of humor, which I have always. So, those are all of the questions asked from Wolf Mother Wednesdays, Freaky Fridays, and Hyrule Hobby Sundays questions. Right, on to your guys' questions, which you asked in the last Q&A. Lily Nightfall asks, great video, it was funny to hear about how you and Kuja get competitive against each other. Don't throw the controller, I try not to. But, rage and crap, and do you know how many times my dad has actually fixed my controller? It's a ridiculous amount, I can't count. Do you ever repaint your dolls to look like characters from other things than what they originally from? Different movies, shows, video games, or books? I actually have a plan on making some of the Final Fantasy characters into dolls. Those are kind of like a future kind of repainting video that I have planned. I do have kind of this little lovely one, this little lovely doll here, which is Handsome Jack, which is from the game Borderlands 2 and pre-sequel. So, I have repainted a couple into kind of like a video game. I also have my FNAF series as well, which is Five Nights at Freddy's. And I have done those, which is I think it was an indie horror game, which is a good game. I like that game. But, I mean, movies and shows, books, I mean, I like books and I like movies and I like shows. I just don't have this particular interest into actually making them into dolls. I mean, it's especially hard when it's coming from a book where it's words and not images. But I do like doing video game conversions. Again, I have Borderlands 2 and pre-sequel of Handsome Jack. And I also have my Five Nights at Freddy's conversions as well. Thank you for your question, Lily. Inibir 40k asked, that is pretty romantic. It's quite romantic. The question for next time, where do you see your channel in a year's time? Great video as always, even with the singing. I thought that the singing was a little bit, I thought it was a little bit like too much, but actually you guys seem to like it, so I mean, that's awesome, because that's kind of like my personality trait. I love singing, well, very badly, but where do I see my channel in a year's time? I see my channel as still a small channel, but I see my channel as doing more kind of repainting videos and kind of sharing you guys how I do things more. I don't actually know. I mean, I don't expect myself to get super famous, but I mean, when it comes to subscribers, you know, I don't really see my channel as being a big channel. But I see it being a lot more relatable and a lot more kind of out, like, a more of a channel that you wouldn't see normally. It wouldn't be a Let's Play channel or a wargaming channel or a beauty channel. It would be a doll repainting channel. And there's not many of those out there. So my pretty much goal is to try and get doll repainting a lot more kind of out there as opposed to my own channel. I mean, if my channel gets to that point, I'll be always appreciative on that one. But I don't see my channel being very big still in a year's time. But I feel that I would have a lot more content that will be relatable for you guys, you know, to kind of watch instead of me just showing you what I have done and not how I've done it. So thank you for your question, Edikbir. I always look forward to your questions. Freak from the channel Frosten Fisk. What's a hard today? Frost and Fist. Freak asks, wonderful Q&A as always. I can't wait to see you in your element as you video while you're painting. I actually look forward to showing you guys how I repaint these. There's a lot of, I mean, my dolls are a lot different, you know, from each other. They all have different personalities. Well, personalities, traits. I'm a crazy person. But I can't wait to show you guys how I do these things. So, the question of the week. Right. Let's go. When you come to the States, what would be the first American food you try? I had to think about that one for a while. I mean, I only pretty much had yesterday and a little bit of today to actually think about this. But, the first food I would like to try when I come to the States is actually, it's not a home cooked meal. It's actually, I would love to kind of get an insight of kind of like, I want to try your donuts. The donuts look really good, and I'm going to cheat on his. The first food I would try is probably, you know, what you guys, you know, home cook, you know, what your tradition is. But if I was going on to the takeaway stage, you know, kind of like the takeout type of thing, it'll probably be your burgers, because your burgers look incredibly good. Or your donuts, it depends. But I would like to try some of your hometown dishes. I've heard a lot about them, and I want to eat them all. So, I think it would be your hamburgers would be the first American food that I would want to try. But I would like to try biscuits and gravy. That sounds really good. Lots of love, Freak. Lots of love to you, buddy, and thank you for your question. I know these aren't long answers, but... Tattoo for you, Richard asks. He asked two questions this time. What's up, buddy? What color do you find you use the most in repainting? And what is your dream repaint doll you've... Ooh. What is your dream repaint a doll you've wanted but can't find? I'm going to ask you, your first question is, what color do I find I use the most in room painting? It's got to be black. because, again, I have a lot of uncommon demons in my little collection, so it's gotta be black, even though that's the one color that I don't have to replace that much. I mean, I'm still on my first pot, really. I mean, of seeing how many dolls I have, you wouldn't think I would have run out and on my second pot by now. But I use a lot of black, like a lot. Like an unusual amount of black. And that's the color I use most in repainting. It's Abaddon black. I think is how you pronounce it. If not, just slap me silly and correct me. But Abaddon black, I use that a lot. And what is your dream repaint a doll you wanted but just can't find? My dream repaint, I've always wanted to kind of try and repaint. I'll try and do like I'm assuming it's like a project type of thing. If not, just correct me down below. But my dream repaint. I've always wanted to find the three-eyed doll, and I've always wanted to repaint that into an orc. But changing color tones in dolls is a little bit more challenging than most people would think. So I just, I don't have time to actually change their color tone. And I wanted to make like a three-eyed orc. Or another project for the three-eyed doll is to make the mutated fish from The Simpsons. Again, there's a lot of parts, I have to kind of make the thing into like a movable tail and make kind of the color scheme and whatnot, but it will be either an orc, a three-eyed orc, or the mutated fish from The Simpsons. But I can't find that doll anywhere. I've looked on eBay, I've looked on Amazon, I've even looked at Argos, Asda, Toys R Us. I can't find it anywhere. It's kind of, I've seen it around in the group I'm in of Monster High Catacombs, but I can't seem to find it. I can't find it even at a very decent price. I just can't find it anywhere. It doesn't pop up. I just can't find it. I don't even know what her name is. Most people actually don't know what her real name is. Most people do, but every time I ask, they don't really comment back. But I can't find it anywhere. Nowhere. But that's the answer to your question, Richard. If I've got anything wrong within the question, please correct me down in the comments below. But thank you for your question, Richard. I always look forward to your questions. Dark Light Dreamer, hey dude. Great answers, Kibi, as always. Smiley face. For next time... Oh, there's two questions in here. If you could live in any fantasy world from a game, anime, or movie, what would it be and why? And if you could have special powers or abilities, what would they be? I'm going to start with the first question, which is if you could live in any fantasy world from a game, anime, or movie, what would it be and why? It's from a game. It's a little place called Albion from the Fable trilogies, and it's kind of like this big kind of world. Albion is the whole entire. I think it's the whole entire world or the place. I've been never sure, but it's from the Fable series. So it's from the Lost Chapters, originated from Xbox, and then Fable 2, Infinite Fable 3, and I would love to live there because it's like kind of like a Victorian English town where you could be a hero and stuff like that, and it's a really fun place to be. I'm gonna cheat on this one as well and go, I would love to live in a Borderlands world. I would love to live in the pre-sequel world, I would love to just like to live on Pandora, just in general. No, I would love to live in the Borderlands 2 world or Pandora, because it just looks amazing. I mean, it's every man for himself. So I think my best pick will be Pandora from Borderlands, since it's just like an amazing world. There's so much to do, And, I mean, it's every man for themselves, so... That would be a fantasy world from a game that I would love to actually be in. But again, it's just a fantastic big open space world. And come on, who doesn't want to kill a skag every so often? My point! Your second question was, if you could have special powers or abilities, what would they be? I would love to be able to teleport and mind read. I would love to teleport because I can teleport anywhere I would like. And I also like with the teleporting space, I would love to actually like be able to teleport more than just me, or like to teleport like more than one person. So then come on, teleporting to you guys. I mean, it's free. And it'll be awesome. So I would love to have teleporting and mind reading. So as creepy as that sounds, Mark's chair fell. I'm leaving that in. Let me just. Okay. Nope. I made a mess. Let's continue answering your question, Dark. So I would love to mind read. So then, if you know someone needs help with something, I could kind of like help them with that and kind of get more understanding of who they are and whatnot. And I like to mind read. I mean, I like to know what someone is about. But I mean, it sounds kind of creepy. But I mean, it'll be a good ability. So then I know when someone is lying, which will be great. So thank you for your questions, Darklight. Again, with all of you guys, I love getting questions from you. You know, your questions are awesome and I love answering them. So thank you for your question, Darklight. Child. That's literally his name is Child. Well, it's not your name, but Child asks from Facebook. What color do you hate painting the most? White. Hands down white. Because no matter how pigmented it is, no matter how much you try, it always takes more than one layer for it to be completely opaque. And that's just... It's not a horrible color. It's a nice color. It complements most things. I just hate painting with it. Again, it's kind of like it's very hard to make opaque. So, thank you for your question, Child. I have three for this one. Mythos from the channel Frost and Fists asks, I can speak today, I promise. Excellent episode, my friend. Sorry I'm so late. You're fine. You're okay. You know, you're fine. You're okay. Even if you're late, as long as I get this episode at least on Thursday, it's fine. I also love Death Note and Tenchi. They are my two favorites. For next time, question number one. Top three favorite movies. Two favorite birthday presents ever. And three, love your silver hair. Thank you. Do you have a favorite character that also has silver hair? Much love, my friend. Wolf Brother Mythos. Thank you for your questions, Mythos. Top three favorite movies. They're all Tim Burton movies. I like Corpse Bride, Nightmare Before Christmas, and Coraline. I love those three. Those three are amazing. I do because they're Tim Burton and they're very, very creepy. But I like creepy. Not too creepy, but I like creepy. Favorite birthday presents ever? Having you guys. Period. There has been a couple of birthday presents other than actual objects that I like. Mark bought me a couple of dolls that I've been needing and wanting for a while. to finish my Scary Reef collection and also my Freak the Sheet collection. Those were awesome. That's a Christmas present, excuse me. My nan buying me the Lady Gaga Fame perfume, which I miss having. And I love everything that my mum buys me. I love every present my mum buys me. So I can't pick kind of one from my mother and my parents. So it's every birthday present that I've ever received from mum, which is a lot. I can't mention all of them. But every present that my parents have ever bought me are my favorite presents. So, my favorite birthday presents. So, yes. Next question. Do I have a favorite character that also has silver hair? I do. I like an anime called Soul Eater, and Stein is amazing. He's probably one of my most favorite characters. Obviously, because he is, you know, a stitched up character. I think it was Professor Stein, but I just called him Stein. So Stein from Soul Eater, I think it's more grey than silver, but I like to think it's more silver. So, I mean, it's a lot darker silver than mine is, but I love Stein. He's kind of like this, like, kind of, you know, he's serious, you know, he knows what he's doing, and then sometimes he just goes loopy, and then every so often he'll go on his little, like, nut. So, I've always wanted to do that. It was so satisfying. Thank you for your question, Mythos. And thank you to all of you who actually submitted questions. I love answering every question you guys have. So that is the end of the Q&A. Sorry it's such a long Q&A. I got a lot of questions this week. So, and I enjoy, you know, having these questions. So don't forget to go subscribe and give love to the channels down below in the description. And I'm actually going to ask a question for you guys. What is your most favoritist miniature that you want, but you either can't afford it or can't have it? So, like, you know, if I was to answer my own question, I've always wanted the Elizabeth 17-inch doll, and I'll be getting it soon, not very soon, for my anniversary. Thank you, Kujahara. But I had always wanted it, you know, because she's pretty, she's beautiful. It's probably one of the dolls I might not even repaint. But so that's my question for the week, and it will be my first question of the week. What miniature or something in your hobby have you always wanted but either can't have or can't afford? So would love hearing your answers to your questions. Either comment down below, or if you have your own Q&A show, answer it there if you want to. Answer it anywhere. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it for you guys, and as always, I'll see you in the next audio video. Stay plastic.